I don't know if you guys ever played this game back in the day. So on Nintendo 64, there was a really cool racing game by the name of Extreme G. This was the very first racing game that got me into electronic music, like trance music, stuff like that. And when I first played this game, I was like, whoa, this game is so awesome. It's so fast. And the music, the whole soundtrack in every level really fit the whole theme of the game, and it really fit the pace. This game was in a way similar to F-Zero in terms of, I'd say, graphics and the game speed, but it differed because F-Zero had like Nintendo kind of music. I think there were like two songs I liked on F-Zero, but by the way, I'm talking about F-Zero X here, the one on Nintendo 64. But this one was a game where you actually had weapons. It was a really fast game too, but you had like these kind of two-wheeled motorbikes instead of flying like jets and these bigger vehicles in F-Zero X. Now I'm not taking away anything from F-Zero X. It is a really good game as well, but I preferred this one simply because I got these cool weapons and I had this kick-ass music to listen to. So. This is only gameplay for one level, just so you guys know. I didn't really need that many levels to show you guys what the game is like. There were very few racing games that I've really gotten into back in the day. Like, this was one of them, F-Zero was another, and Mario Kart was another one. There weren't really that many on PlayStation or even PC back then that I really found interesting. We also had a 3DO. Road Rash, I think that was the name of it. I played it a little bit, but this one is still my all-time favorite. I think there was Extreme G2 that made, it made it on N64, and I'm trying to think. I think there was Extreme G3 on PS2, I'm trying to say. I think it was on PS2, or was it on GameCube? I'm not too sure. So I don't know if they kept making Extreme G games after the third one. I kind of lost track. But this was the game that really got me into electronic music. It was so badass. And even though all the vehicles kind of looked similar in kind of the design, like, you know, they're all two-wheeled motorcycles, they had very slight changes to them. The weapons, I think, were not the main factor of the game because they weren't that easy to use. It was more about trying to get the lead and keeping the lead and trying to maintain your speed on turns and very long areas. But this has been Extreme G. I hope you guys actually enjoyed this video. If you guys have played this game, what are your thoughts on it? Yeah, I love the music. It's so good. So, see you later.